thought we said 8:15.
No, everything's fine. No, I'm not getting a cold. I'm running late now.
Okay, okay. You know what? You got me.
I actually do. I have two men in my bed and one in the closet.
Right. I miss you too.
Five, four, three, two.
It's 9:28. I'm Jerry DePalma, and welcome to The Opening Bell. Today we're talking with Evan Mitchell, Chief Investment Strategist for Belmont Stevens. Thanks for stopping by.
No problem.
Let's talk about market trends. Mm-hmm. Now, with the six-month dip in over-the-counter stocks, blue chips have been on a surprising tandem rise. Mm-hmm. What's your explanation?
Well, common sense, really. I think generally when people lose money, they turn to the old reliables, like Boeing, GM.
What about media giant Janssen Field? Mm-hmm. 6 months ago, you issued a strong buy for the company.
Right.
Do you think they're still in for a similar upswing?
Janssen made some smart purchases early in the year, but I'm not blown away by their current market strategy.
Meaning you don't expect them to have a solid first quarter?
Well, I'm downgrading my recommendation from strong buy to hold, so you tell me.
Downgrade my ass. Some moose wearing stock jock speaks on TV, and suddenly I'm bleeding green? No, I got something he can hold right here. Now, if he's dissing Janssen, then he's dissing me. Hurt me, hurt my family, and nobody hurts my family. Let me see that. The stock keeps dropping. Dishman, what kind of business manager are you? No, don't tell me that trend lines are still up. My deal is for profit sharing, not profit losing.
Calm down.
Who is this doom talking Mitchell cat anyway?
Oh, hey guys. Good to know that my mom wasn't the only one watching.
Good morning, Evan.
Oh, good morning.
Can I have your autograph?
Oh, yeah, you want my autograph, huh? Star is born. Where should I sign?
Right where it says recipient.
Oh, I get it.
Actually, there's some men waiting for you in the conference room.
Really? All right. Can I help you, fellas?
Evan freaking Mitchell.
Hey, what?
Oh! You to use your head instead of your mouth this morning, I wouldn't be here. Repeat after me. I am one dumbass animal. Say it! I am one dumbass analyst. Upgrade Janssen. Or the stock won't be the only thing that's dropping. You dig?
Bad news?
New York's finest lost our disgruntled friend on the FDR.
How do you lose somebody who has an entire entourage?
I'll find him. He's famous.
Yeah, for what? Causing grown men to pee on themselves?
That was Urban Decay. Daryl Knowles.
The rap singer?
Yeah, he's got that song, Baby Got Shelf.
Yeah. Baby Got Shelf. Girl, you know it's true. Damn. Your shelf's so nice and smooth. What? I'm a connoisseur of tail. I admit to own a copy.
Right. Anyway, he's also known for blowing his top. I read somewhere that he kicked an actress out of his car because she wouldn't take care of business.
Yeah, well, there he was impatient. I mean, you can't blame him for that.
No, the car was still moving.
So he's impatient and homicidal?
And those are his good traits.
But why Mitchell?
The Janssen Field downgrade. Urban Decay's music is distributed through a Janssen subsidiary.
So he's probably got stock options, which means Mitchell's downgrade would have cost the guy a bundle.
Yeah. Evans over at St. Vincent's getting cleaned up, but he's going to be fine right now. We need to focus. I'll make this quick so we can all get back to work. Listen up, people. Some of you may have heard rumors that the firm is acquiring French Merchant Bank, Credit Toulouse. Well, those rumors are correct. By 12 midnight Thursday, Belmont Stevens goes international. Because a number of deals are already in place, I'll need to get some people to Paris ASAP. If any of you want to go, I'll be happy to consider it. But you'll have to put your name in the hat now, or you'll miss your chance. By 6 p.m. tomorrow, you'll be cleaning out your desks. 8 hours after that, you'll be saying au revoir.
Freddie Sacker's line. Oh, hi, Mrs. Sacker. Yeah, let me see if I can find him.
Okay, just say, I want to have sex in time.
Bona fortuna.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I think he's picking up some Italian for lunch. Yep, you too.
Oh, oops.
Can I help you with that?
Oh, thanks. I have a presentation upstairs in like 5 minutes. I'm a total wreck. Could you do me a favor?
I'm a little busy right now.
Could you just check my CD player? I can't get the CD to work.
Yeah, sure.
Take a look.
Looks, good to me. I really should be getting back to work. Now.
Do you see what happens when you leave your seat?
If you're one of the party games, Sweet Cheeks, I'll be there.
So how come my sister never gave me a present like that?
Makes you wonder about a sister, huh?
Are you gonna go tonight?
What do you care? Suddenly you're interested in my plans again?
Come on, no.
I'm serious. What happened to the model?
Look, it was normal.
It sure seemed like something to me.
Hey, look. Clean slate, all right? We'll go, we'll have some fun. Say yes.
Are you sure it's safe to socialize with me?
Well, there's only one way to find out.
Discussion on international. Thank you very much, Tom. That sounds great. Thanks.
So, what did Dudek have to say? Should we be planning a bon voyage party?
What are you talking about?
The Paris job. I heard you made the shortlist.
Doesn't mean I'm going.
Why not? I mean, it sounds like the perfect exit strategy for a broken engagement.
And when did you become such an expert in my personal life?
You guys are very popular. It's all anyone talks about around here.
Good to know.
Listen, I just want you to know I think it's horrible the way Jack made you suffer. Regardless of what you two went through, no one deserves to be treated that way.
Sometime I'll take you out for drinks to tell you all about it. In the meantime, I've got a filing that's due.
Well, I just want you to know I'm glad that you're getting this chance to start over.
Bridget, who says I'm going anywhere?
Fact is, folks, what women think is an orgasm is really nothing more than a crotch sneeze. My company, Pleasure Trends, has created a drug that turns that moment into as much as 3 hours of heightened arousal, as long as the appropriate stimulation is provided.
It's the inappropriate stimulation that interests me.
Currently, Paradise is in stage 2 trials, but market conditions indicate it's the wrong time to go public.
So how big a mezzanine round are you looking for?
About $20 million that should last us until the IPO.
Aren't you getting a little bit ahead of yourself? I mean, you still got a dozen FDA hurdles to jump.
Wouldn't call 2 years of test results premature. Women need this product.
Oh, so you know what women need? Seriously, if the major pharmaceuticals haven't unveiled the female Viagra yet, don't you think it's a little bit unrealistic that a tiny startup like Pleasure Trends would beat them to it?
Small companies sometimes have big ideas, Miss,
Miller.
3 hour orgasms.
You'd have to schedule it in your calendar.
Or take a vacation day.
Guys, you don't think this thing actually works, do you?
I don't know.
Hey, man.
Yes.
Count me in, all right? Oh, yeah, and if you need a guinea pig couple, my lady and I, we're locked and loaded.
Thanks, I'll keep that in mind.
As my colleague indicated, we will, of course, need to do a little more research before we can proceed. Shall we reconvene this time tomorrow?
Whatever it takes, I'm in this for the long haul. Thank you.
I think it shouldn't be a problem.
Excuse me, Miss Miller. Listen, after that ringing endorsement, can I at least take you to lunch?
Sorry, I have lunch.
Dinner.
Plans.
A pretzel. How about a pretzel?
You're good.
Everything went great. Nice color, steady stream.
What are you talking about?
I don't know. What else could you possibly need to know that couldn't wait 2 minutes?
Paris. Divac offered me the banking division. I'm going to tell him yes, unless you give me a reason not to.
Wow. We're going to do this right here, right now?
If you don't want to marry me, then let me start over. I can't keep living like this. I feel like I've been punished enough.
I'm not trying to punish you, Al.
Tom wants someone in Paris by the weekend.
What is this? Marry me or else?
I still love you, Jack. I can't stand you at the moment, but I still love you. And I don't want to lose you.
Apparently you're willing to risk that.
You know where to find me.
We now go live.
Oh, check it out.
Mr. Mitchell.
Mr. Mitchell, is it true that you're filing charges against rapper Urban DK Knowles?
Absolutely. Mr. Knowles should know that having money doesn't mean he can go around hurting people. I mean, yeah, I guess he's a talented musician and a true, successful businessman, but basically he's a whack job who's better suited to spend time on Rikers than on Wall Street.
Oh,
thanks.
So Mitchell's pressing charges against DK.
Does that surprise anybody?
Well, apparently it surprised Jansen Field. I just got a call from banking. Jansen's sending a lawyer over this afternoon to talk about it.
So, you didn't buy a word I said in there, did you?
Well, when something seems too good to be true, it generally is.
Hey, the data speaks for itself. A lot of time and research went into this.
Doing what? Watching people have sex?
You know, I happen to believe in what I do.
Seems like nice work if you can get in. Hello? Hello?
Almond certainly knows how to woo a client. You know, Bear Stearns only offered me a weekend in Aspen.
Hello? Oh, my God. You think we're on the 20th floor?
When do you think they're going to get here? All right, well, let us know. Thanks. This is a nightmare.
Funny. Some women actually enjoy my company.
I'm sorry. I'm just not good in these cramped, dark spaces.
Question. How come you're so resistant to my product?
You're peddling orgasms. What can I say? I'm a skeptic. Are you married, Mr. Bishop?
I was. Didn't work out.
Oh. So now you're like this single guy cruising around with this ultimate chick magnet?
Give me a break. I did not develop this drug so I could hit on women.
Oh. Why did you develop this drug?
Frankly, I think women deserve it. Tell me, when was the last time you really climaxed? I mean the big O.
The big O?
Big O.
This morning, in the shower before work.
3 hours worth?
What's up? You've been zoning for like an hour.
Sorry. Alex and I had a little talk before.
Oh, what now?
Bottom line, unless I marry her, she's moving to Paris.
So suddenly she's the one with the ultimatum and you're actually considering it? What is wrong with this picture?
I have to consider it, right?
You have to... Jack, can I speak honestly with you?
Shoot.
Okay. I would rather have my pubic hairs waxed than go through this again with you. Because most men, they break up, they got one round of makeup sex, and then they call it a day. You, on the other hand, you're like a freaking... You're like a glutton for punishment. I mean, this is just... Tell him.
Well?
It is starting to get annoying, yes.
And we're your friends. I mean, imagine how other people feel.
Other people? When was the last time you spoke to that old, you know, college buddy of yours, Vince?
2 months ago. He's got a new kid at home. He's very busy.
Busy. Jack, knock, knock. The guy would rather wipe a baby's ass than go out and have a beer with you. Because you keep repeating the same problem freaking over and over and over.
Sorry I brought it up.
Hey. We're just trying to be straight with you, Jack.
Thanks.
No, Jack, I mean, come on. Just put your rocks on the line and make a decision already. Because we don't want to hear about this anymore.
Hey, you guys hear about Catherine?
No, what? Did a house fall on her?
Yeah, she and that pharmaceutical guy got stuck in an elevator together.
Come on.
Really?
Wait a second. How long is she in there?
I don't know, about an hour. Why?
Well, you know, how long is Miss Tall, Dark, and Frigid going to be in the box? Opening bid's 50. Who's in?
Start taking bets? What if something happens in there? Are you going to be able to live with that?
Oh, please. It's nothing a charitable donation can't cure. Will you just please lighten up? Okay, windows open, boys and girls. You got to be in it to win it.
Alex.
Jack, did you need something?
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
First of all, it should be noted that this is purely a business discussion. My client returned here on his own volition. He is aware of Mr. Mitchell's desire to press charges against him, but prefers to try to settle this like mature adults.
Mature adults. Oh, do you hear those sirens outside? Is that that's your ride?
You threatening me?
Yeah. You know what? Pick another window, bro. I'm game.
That's enough. You know, I ought to whip you right upside your head.
That would make sense. You should whip me upside my head, because, you know, once you're upstate, what's another couple years?
Gentlemen, right? Gentlemen.
He started it.
Jensenfield regrets what transpired, and to avoid any unnecessary legal action, believes this can be worked out amicably.
What'd you have in mind, Mr. Cohn?
Doing a great deal of business with your firm.
Oh, God.
Well, of course, we would like to work with Jensenfield.
Yeah, but this was a personal attack against Evan, so if he wants to press charges, that's his decision to make.
Hmm. Thank you, Jack.
Surely Belmont has some influence over the actions of its employees.
You're kidding me. This is insanity. This is insanity!
Why don't we talk about this outside?
What's to talk about, man? This is a matter of respect. This is a matter of principle.
It's a matter of business, Mr. Mitchell.
Okay, no one's talking to you, Johnny Cochran. Why don't you settle in, huh? All right, you know, if you want me to drop the charges, all right, so the suits upstairs can refurbish their summer homes in Hampton.
Please
what, man? Please what? Please crawl under a rock with this criminal's hush money?
Call him a criminal. That's a defamation of character.
Oh, man, you know what? You don't have any character. Why don't you just sit your hip-hop ass down and shut up?
Wait a minute, Mr. Knowles. Mr. Knowles, please, just sit down.
What are you going to throw down in front of the lawyer? Ridiculous. All right. What's it going to be, Tom? Oh, come on. Okay. Thanks for your support.
Excuse me.
So what happened to your marriage?
Oh, a lot of things. Stress. We both had hard jobs. Apparently, I wasn't delivering between the sheets. you know, with my wife, it was either come or go. That, among other things. When she left, I was devastated.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. While my marriage didn't work out, at least I found something I loved to do. It's okay. We're okay. We're okay. Nothing's gonna happen.
Nothing.
Absolutely nothing.
Hours.
crime rates and market forces that affect them will be held today at 6 p.m.
Yeah. All right, let me ring you back. Okay, we got a market adjustment. The elevator duo's in for 6 hours easy. Who's along for the ride?
Come on, they dangled him out of a 27-story window. We cave in, we send a message that Belmont puts money ahead of its employees.
Belmont is doing what it needs to do to stay alive. Now, if that means taking advantage of an employee's misfortune, come bonus time, that employee would be duly compensated.
Regardless of whether or not it's the right thing to do?
This is Wall Street, Jack. There is no right thing to do.
You don't believe that.
You know as well as I do that we all have our price. Is that wrong? Maybe. But it's going to take more than Evan Mitchell to change things.
You got the report?
Okay,
that's great. Here you go, Toby. No, I'll take a look at it. Thank you.
Growth fund potential tapes are now available. Please see Mr. Paxton for your copies.
They going to be all right? Well, we've done everything we can safety-wise. It's purely mechanical now.
Yes, so what are we thinking, Chief? Midnight? Wee hours? Bitch, it's getting pretty pungent in there, huh?
Could be early morning. What's it to you?
Oh, well, you know, when they get out, Ben Franklin and I need a phone call. Follow?
Hi.
Mind if I come in?
Sure. I was just getting ready to leave. Do you want to sit down?
Listen. I've been thinking about the job. And us. Come on, Alex. Are you, Paris, are you really ready to walk away
What's
like that?
What's keeping me here? I can't keep waiting on you, Jack. It's torture.
You think it's easy for me?
I need to know what you want. You have to understand that.
I know what I don't want. I don't want you to go. Let's give it another shot.
That's all I needed to hear.
Yeah. Oh man, if there's a cover charge, Sherman's buying me lunch tomorrow. Army, thanks. Excuse me, thanks.
This one's going to be a little late. So if you have any other problems, just let me know, okay?
Hey, buddy, what's up? We're here for the party.
Nice suit. Dolce? Do you know her?
Whoa. Okay, which uptown girl's gonna go downtown with Uncle Freddy?
I'd say Tim comes from some serious bucks.
I think that's a definite possibility.
Hey, guys! I'll talk to you guys in a minute. Hey, you made it! Mm-hmm. Fantastic!
There's the man of the hour. Happy birthday, bud.
Oh, thanks.
Wow, looking good, Sherman. So tell me, let's cut to the quick. How rich are you?
Hey, we let the kid relax for one night? Come on.
Yeah, give him a break, Freddy.
All right, I get the hint. First thing tomorrow, your nose is deep and brown again.
So, drinks, food, we got it all.
No, take it easy. It's your party tonight, we'll take care of ourselves.
Great, enjoy.
Woo! Oh, boy. Hello.
So, wanna dance?
Hmm?
Dance. Hi.
Let's just hang out for a while. All right?
I don't know.
What are we doing?
This is the fire department. You two okay?
Hanging in there.
Listen, the emergency cable's working perfectly. Unfortunately, these new elevators can't be bypassed without a specialist.
Where's the specialist?
Cleveland.
So, do you travel with inventory?
Always.
Yo, heads up.
Just the guys I want to see before bedtime. Charmaine, Tito.
Would you like a scotch?
No, thanks.
What's this about?
You don't look so bad.
Oh, yeah? Bad or bad good?
Mr. Mitchell, my client knows he has anger management issues. This morning, you were the focus of those problems and suffered because...
Right, yeah, no, I do have a vague recollection, particularly the part where I wet myself and begged for mommy.
In consideration for the physical and emotional damage he inflicted, we would like to offer you a check for $100,000.
Right. So this is what it's come down to, huh? Late night meetings in payola. That's pretty pathetic.
It's business, nothing more.
Right. Okay. So what about him? Right. He's the one who flips out, and somehow I'm the bad guy. Why is that?
Sometimes the world just isn't fair. Cuz.
Oh, hey. You know what? Cuz, bite me. Okay. It's fairer than you think. So I'll tell you what. You can keep your bribe and your half-assed apology. I know. I'm sorry, Tom. I'm not being a good team player, but this sucks.
Evan, you're exhausted. You don't have to make this decision.
Now. It's too late, all right? The charge is aggravated assault. I'll see you in court, homie.
Herman's room was packed. I hate waiting in lines.
I'm Chris.
Jillian, I'm Tim's sister.
No way. This is some party. Do you throw bashes like this often?
From time to time, when it's worth it. Tim's a good kid.
He's the best.
So tell me, how long have you been hitting on women in public restrooms?
Actually, I was sort of looking for you.
I was joking.
I'm not.
You're a traitor at Belmont, right?
Soup gave it away, huh?
I know most of Tim's friends. You're different. Cuter. I figure you work together.
Listen, maybe we should get out of here. What do you think?
Watch you guys.
It's okay, miss. Don't you worry. We're on our way.
Oh, let me take that for you.
Thanks.
Hey, little brother. Yeah. Having fun?
Yeah, great. Great. Only remember, I work with these people. You got any other surprises for me here?
Yeah, they're sending the bill to you.
What?
Kidding.
No, seriously. Who's paying for this?
Just relax and have fun.
Come on, Jillian.
Oh, we have to talk to you.
All right, steady pulse.
Mm-hmm.
Your heart's good. Well, great lungs.
Can we go soon?
We just got here. I think that we should at least say hello to the birthday boy.
We can say hello tomorrow.
Let's put in an appearance and go home.
Oh. I like the way that sounds. Home. I can't wait to climb into our bed again. Fall asleep with you lying next to me.
Don't say anything about sleeping.
Home.
Coach.
Leave it in.
Now.
Yes.
It's all gonna work out because I'm a doctor.
Oh yeah.
You're crazy. Can I get a cosmopolitan?
Gotcha.
I'll get a vodka rocks.
Yeah, coming up.
You disappeared.
Yeah, well, I'm the hostess. I had guests to attend to.
Oh, so you weren't just blowing me off?
With a smile like that, how could I?
Well, something tells me it's happened before.
Cool. So you're calling me a tease?
Well, aren't you?
Depends. Do you like it?
Very much.
Then why question a good thing?
Cosmo?
Thanks.
Sure. Vodka rocks.
So, tell me about yourself.
What do you want to know?
I don't know. Try me. I'm open to suggestions.
Everything you see is courtesy of Dunkirk Sherman.
Paper company.
Third generation. Tim doesn't like people to know.
Don't worry, I'll still treat him like crap. So, do you work?
At an arts foundation.
That must keep you out of trouble.
Not really.
That's it? Oh no. Let me guess, you got guests to attend to.
I'm a tease, remember? Thanks for the dance.
Huh?
We really have to go to work.
You can take a sick day.
Yeah, I feel sick.
So, were you really gonna pack your bags?
Move to Paris?
And forget about me?
Would you believe 2 out of 3?
Seriously, what about your family?
My parents would love visiting Europe.
Well, your friends are here. You'd get lonely.
In Paris?
You don't even speak French.
I had my first Berlitz course. Je suis une femme d'affaires, monsieur.
It just feels right. This. Right now. If I'd let you go.
Shh. I was gonna go, Jack, but I'm not going anymore. Not without you.
I'm glad you stayed.
I'm glad you asked me to.
Well, here we go. Glad you two are okay.
Welcome back.
Welcome back to the world.
All right.
Weissenberger. It's all yours, 21 hours. Do you notice anything different about the Spider-Woman?
She looks great.
Yeah, exactly. Only two things will make her that happy. My resignation and an overdue visit to the boneyard.
Somebody looks like they weathered the storm pretty well.
Never better.
I hope this hasn't changed your mind about doing business with us.
No, not at all. It's a little rough, but I think Miss Miller and I came to a professional understanding.
We have to finance those pills.
Drink that, you'll feel better.
Does it have arsenic in it?
I had a long talk with your sister last night.
Yeah, I saw.
She's great.
Yeah, she seemed to like you too.
I want to ask her out sometime.
Unless that's a problem. Do you really think that's such a good idea?
What are you saying?
I don't know. She's my sister. You're my boss.
Jillian's a big girl, Sherman. I'm sure she can take care of herself.
She's not the one I'm worrying about.
Look, I'm just trying to be polite here. But, why don't you just give me your number?
I really don't have much of a choice here, do I?
No, not really.
Okay.
Need a pen?
Yeah.
How about a bagel?
No.
Au revoir. Never try to assemble a staff from 5,000 miles away.
Yeah, that's what I want to talk to you about. I hope I'm not screwing things up for you with Alex.
How's that?
Oh, I don't know if she told you, but we're working things out. She's not going to be taking the Paris job.
Well, I appreciate your concern, but it's a bit presumptuous considering she's never been formally offered the position.
What?
Well, she showed her enthusiasm, and yes, she is on a short list of candidates, but... But I guess that's all moot now, isn't it?
Harley Crouch, Bagmore Truck, on 1.
Congratulations, Jack. I expect an invite.
Harvey.
So I've been reviewing Urban DK's criminal record. You're not the first financial consultant he's lost patience with.
You're kidding, yes.
Well, he ran over a guy from Solomon, put him in traction for 3 months.
Really?
Yeah, combine that with the pending lawsuits against two bellhops and a kid at a fast food drive-thru. We should see court time somewhere around 2007.
2007? No. See, I need people to know about this right away. I mean, doesn't bad press hurt this guy's reputation?
Not really.
Not really.
He's a rapper, Evan. He be bad. The better he be, the more he sells. He actually did him a favor.
I did him a favor now.
And maybe we should include that in the first settlement request. What do you think?
I should have taken $100,000.
He offered you money? When?
Last night.
And you didn't call me? What are you, a moron? $100,000. We're lucky if we're gonna see half of that. You think I got 6 years to waste on this, Mitchell? I'm out of here.
Barry.
This is not just a sex supplement. This could be the female pharmaceutical of the 21st century.
That's not what the research indicates. 62% of the women polled said, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. 72% of the men said that they really didn't care.
They haven't tried it.
Consumers haven't tried it. Most clinical studies show it could have the efficacy of a sugar pill.
I don't think so.
I'm sorry. The data speaks for itself. It's a pass.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. There's other banks. The important thing is, when can we get together?
Oh, you know, I have something to do tomorrow. This charity dinner. And then Friday I have yoga from 6 to 8, and after that I go away for the weekends.
So you're busy.
3 hours are hard to find.
When's your next opening?
A week from Wednesday?
You pencil me in. I guess we just redefine the one-night stand. Wish me luck.
Chris McConnell.
Just some Wall Street guy who works with my brother.
So, call me back. Call me back at Beaumont. You know the number. All right, I'll talk to you soon.
Matterhorn's showing a gigantic third quarter loss. This isn't the time for them to play hardball. Listen, can I call you back? I'm calling you back. Hey.
Hey.
Guess where I got us into for dinner tonight? John's Pizza. Doesn't pizza sound good?
Well, you really know how to pull those strings. Listen, have you told D-Vac you're not taking the Paris job?
Don't worry, I'll get around to it.
Well, I talked to him. What? And he said officially he never offered you the position.
Oh.
Did he?
God's sakes, Jack.
Did you ever have the job, Val?
It was mine if I wanted it.
That's not the impression I got from Tom.
Okay.
I just wish you'd been honest with me.
I was honest. I had the chance to go to Paris.
You talked about it like it was a done deal, and it wasn't.
Okay, Jack, forget about Paris. When push came to shove, you were given a clear choice. You chose me.
Don't start spinning this.
You're spinning this, Jack.
You lied to me. Admit it.
Man,
you lied.
I jumped the gun, but who the hell cares?
I care. I want to trust you, Alex. That's the number one thing to me, trust. That's why I want to get married. I want one person in my life who I trust, who I know isn't working an angle, who doesn't have a hidden agenda, whose motives I don't have to question.
My motive is to be with you. How much clearer can I be?
You've been very clear.
If you're telling me that you're breaking up with me again...
I love you. I really do. But I just don't think that we're right for each other.
No woman's ever going to be good enough for you, Jack. No woman. You want the impossible.
Maybe. Maybe I do.
I just want to be clear on this. There's no coming back. If you say we're through, we're through.
I'm sorry.
You're making a big mistake, Jack. Someday you will realize that.
Someday you'll realize I made the best decision for both of us.
Hey, Jack. I heard the good news. Where are you two registered?
Bridget, for once, mind your own business.
Guess I'm not invited to the wedding.
That's an extraordinary story, Evan. So tell us, what happens now?
Well, look, I'm an analyst, right? I mean, I base my decisions on research and facts. You know, I didn't downgrade that stock to hurt him or to hurt anybody else. You know, I was just doing my job.
Enough of this crap. Who's on Oprah?
Maybe if Urban Decay did his job, instead of watching the market all day long, he'd have another platinum record on his hands, a feat he hasn't pulled off in about 6 years. Business is business. You know what I mean? I'm standing by my downgrade.
Yeah, you're old already.
You know what? Can I get a little extra of that peanut sauce for the noodles?
Oh, yeah, sure. Hi.
Hey.
You make them here?
I do, all the time. I have really good cold noodles.
I'm a mushu man. It's a long way to walk for a good takeout.
It is. It is. It's a nice night, though. So you and Alex got back together.
I thought we were, but no.
Sorry. You okay?
Actually, I am.
Good. That way.
Yeah, I'm that way. Food's getting cold.
Cold noodles, remember? See you tomorrow.
Definitely.
The Street continues late next Friday. Meanwhile, Anthony Hopkins chats to Barry Norman about life, love, and cannibalism in Film Night next.